Has it really been 30 years? Ah, 1977. What a time. Jimmy Carter was president. Seattle SLU won the Kentucky Derby. Oakland beat Minnesota in the Super Bowl. Saturday Night Fever was the new rage. And the beloved Elvis Presley left the building for the last time. Things were different in the world of business and in everyday living, too. The median household income in 1977 was $13,572. In the Mills family, however, it went to zero. Like so many corporate executives, Bill decided he couldn't take it anymore and hatched the idea of starting his own advertising agency. Doesn't everyone want to leave a nice paying, secure job with lots of fringe benefits and leap off the cliff of employment? Naturally, Bill would confide in every friend who would listen about this idea. These included Mary Riggle, a former co-owner of an ad agency who volunteered to come aboard as a part-time employee and teach us the business. Then Bill's dear friend, Woody Briscoe, who was then president of Leasing International, an auto leasing and rental company, said, "Bill, not only will I give you my account, I will also give you office space too." That did it. Bill was hooked. Eloise, the family's guiding force, was less than enthusiastic, but like every other major decision that was important to Bill, she signed on and took charge of finances and making sure that everything ran as it should. Two of the most significant early developments were a friend and fellow Kiwanian, Frank Smith, who gave the agency the privilege of working with his company, Computer Management, which introduced the agency to the technology industry. In addition, Herb Morgan signed on in a freelance role and soon became a full-time member of the WMA team. The agency grew modestly but steadily, first moving into what we thought were fancy digs on Buckhead's East Paces Ferry Road, and then onto our own building on East Shadow Lawn Avenue. This address also became the birthplace of Selling Solutions, a sales promotion and sales consulting firm led by Billy and Susan Paulin that continues to develop major programs for Coca-Cola and other large corporations. 3091 East Shadow Lawn Avenue also holds a very special place in the hearts of the Mills family because it is where both William and Scott met Alicia and Kim. In 1983, William graduated from Florida State University with a degree in advertising and a desire to go to work in the family business. Friends in the Innisbrook Network, a group of agency owners that was co-founded by Bill, told him, "Nobody in their right mind should hire their own kid." One of the requirements of being a member of this network is that you never take any real advice, no matter how sound it is. So we went ahead and hired William. There are few things in life as shocking to a parent as to have their rebellious teenage sons turn into effective, hardworking adults and excellent employees. In business, nothing stays the same, and in the late 80s and early 90s, the small ad agency business underwent major turmoil. While struggling to stay afloat, Bill took a leave of absence to work with the agency's largest client, and William and Eloise assumed leadership responsibilities. It was during this time that William changed the direction of the business to focus on public relations, narrowing new business efforts to the financial industry. While in college at Georgia State University, Scott worked at the agency to earn extra money. After graduation and a brief career as a radio sales representative for a station that almost no one listened to, he resigned and then asked for temporary work just until he found something interesting. Thank goodness, he never found anything as interesting or challenging as WMA. As William and Scott assumed more leadership responsibility, the agency grew and prospered until East Shadow Lawn would no longer accommodate the firm. One day, Scott saw a for sale sign in front of 300 West Wyuka Road, the very building the agency had considered earlier for an office lease. With the considerable skills of our friends and real estate consultants, Workman & Company, the agency sold the East Shadow Lawn property for enough money to make a down payment on new digs and completely renovate and furnish the agency's offices. That's when Alicia and Kim stepped in to design and execute the entire renovation that we continue to enjoy as a result of their skills and considerable work. Under William and Scott's leadership, the William Mills Agency has continued to grow, both in size and in its influence in the industry. They are supported by a capable, seasoned, and dedicated management team that would be the envy of any organization. So what does it take for an agency to survive for 30 years with a future that looks a lot brighter than when it began? For one thing, it takes luck, and we have had our share. Our agency has also been blessed with some incredible clients who have become loyal friends and supporters. We have learned so much from them that has made us more professional. We have also had business partners and our friends in the media that have made invaluable contributions to our success. But the nearest thing we have to a magic formula is a dedicated team of associates who have embraced the agency's philosophy to be the best and to continually work to be better every day. So, happy 30th anniversary, and may we celebrate these occasions together for many years to come.